Yeah. So, good evening to all of you. Thank you very much, Sandeep ji, for inviting me. There's a good news and the bad news. The good news is that I don't have PPT and video. And the bad news is that I'm going to take half an hour. So you're being warned. I'll give some perspective about the business of investing, and I'll also give you perspective of evolution of India, and if you look at the history of India. And I will also talk about the way the various investing habit has been inculcated in us, and what are the transformation we have seen in last 20, 30 years. And there are no short of tectonic transfer. Where we stand today in the journey of investing and Indian economy, and what is going to happen over the next 3, 5, 10, 20 years. So I'll try to take a shot on what we expect to happen in the economy. So first, let's look at India as a country. It is a continuation cultural which is unlike in any other part of the world except China. So if you look at the US or Western world, the America is a country of 400 year old. Australia is a country of 200 plus year old. If you look at the entire European, Europe as a nation, they'll figure out that before the Jesus crisis was born, or the Roman Empire accepted the Christianity, everything got changed. So they completely threw away all their learnings. There was a Greek zero, there was a Latin learning. Everything was destroyed, and say, from this day onward, this is the kind of following we'll have. So they don't have any collective learning, which is more than 2,000 year old. India and China, it is much more longer. If you look at the Gulf region, where the Islam got invented, perhaps in 7th century, and what they did a similar thing. The new Messiah has arrived, so destroyed everything else, and we'll start the new journey. So they don't have the kind of memory which Indian and Chinese do have. And that is the one reason that the biggest consumption of gold happened in India and China. Because traditionally, gold was the best investment option. You could not invest in land. There was no financial assets available. And the gold is the most convenient way to store whatever you had. So that is the reason that India and China continue to lead gold consumption. But here I'm going to give very small prediction about gold. We Indians in next 20 to 30 years are going to disown gold. It may look surprising to many people, but I'll give some illustration. The biggest reason people buy gold in India is a wedding of young boy, young daughter. That is the most important reason given ki bete ki shaadi hai, bete ki shaadi isliye they denge gold. I'll tell you what is happening in this country. 5,000 years back, there was a character called Dhritarashtra in Mahabharata. He wanted a 5,000 son, 100 son. He actually got 100 son and one daughter. Having male child was the thing 20, 30 years back. Any lady in the household didn't have a male child, she doesn't have the same kind of respectability. Today, the world has changed. Having girl child and only girl child is perfectly legitimate thing to have. So we gave away 5,000 years of our history, and we changed in the last 20 to 30 years. Similar kind of thing we see in Dalits. They were untouchable for 5,000 years. But post-independence, there has been a continuous effort to bring them in the mainstream. And today we see there's a positive discrimination happening. Unthinkable. But it's happened in the last 70 years, and the trend will continue. So I'm saying that when we gave up on as close to having our child's gender to be decided by societal norm, forget about the yellow metal we're going to have. One more thing, which is very interesting. In 1987, when I was graduating in my hometown, a colleague of mine, a friend of mine who fell in love, so he came and told his father, he was 18-year boy, he came and told his father, ki papa mujhe is ladke se ishq ho gaya hai. To us time 87 mein kya bola hoga uske papa ne? Bhai kis jaat ki ladki hai? 32 years back, kis jaat ki ladki hai? Today, my 23-year-old son, suppose he comes and tells me, Dad, I'm in love, what will be my question? Ladka hai, ladki hai. Ye hasne ka baat nahi hai, ye haqeeqat hai. Now, when Supreme Court has turned it down and accepted it as a perfectly legitimate thing, our ancestor accepted it as a perfectly legitimate thing. We know the Sikhandi was a character. We know various characters in our mythology which were bisexual, transgender. So we accepted those things. So our society was not. But under the influence of Victorian churches, we accepted these things and moved away from a very open culture to very regimented culture. Now perhaps we are going back to our own open culture. So that is what happened when you look at the gold. Now look at the world history, what has changed and what will happen. Till the beginning of 16th century, India and China were the biggest producer of world GDP. India used to account for 25% of world GDP, China around 20%, 22%. And the reason is very simple. At that time, the mean of GDP production was physical human efforts. So, jis bhi desh mein log jyada honge, unka GDP badhega. Then you had great revolution in US, where the steam engine came into existence. So we've seen huge upsurge in industrial activity in the particularly Western world. They also have naval capacity being built around, and they start colonizing various parts of the world. So Western Europe has become the leader for next 200 years, and then came the US, and now it is the history of China. China is going to take lead in the world. But 20 years from down the line, what will happen? India will take the lead going forward. So whenever you look at the history of any country, we need to keep these things in mind. India is a very difficult country to govern. If you don't believe, we live in a cooperative society structure in Mumbai. If you're a part of the committee member, you'll figure out how difficult it is to rule our own people. We are 100 people, 200 people. Nobody listens to any rule. Everybody wants to have their own rights. Now think of 130 crore people. It is a hell lot of a difficult country to manage. We don't have brand loyalty. We don't have loyalty toward any other product. If you look at Christianity, there's a one God, Jesus. If you look at Islam, there's a one God, Allah. If you look at Hinduism, no single God has more than 1% market share. So that is the kind of country we are living in. So very different kind of country. Now look at world GDP. From 1200 year to 1900 year, for 700 year period, the world GDP expanded by just 1%. Gold was delivering a little better than or equal to that number. So gold was the number one investment option. In India, from 1900 to 1950, for a 50-year period, India's GDP expansion was 0.01%. So from 1900 to 1950, our GDP expanded by 0.01%. Purane log bolte hain, hamare zamane mein mehengai nahi thi. Sahi baat hai. GDP never used to expand. The piece of real estate was used for actual use. You're buying land, it is for agriculture purposes. You're buying something, either to stay or do a business. Real estate as investment is perhaps last 50, 60 year old history. Before that, real estate was more of the time used as an actual consumption item. Now, post-independence, we had a what is called Hindu rate of growth, which was close to 3%. Then in 1980 plus, we had the first round of opening of the economy, which become very faster post-1992. So from 1980, we had GDP growth of 5.5%, and from 1992, on average, India's GDP grew around 7%. Right now, we are looking at 5%, but if you look at old series, we are looking at 3.5% currently. What will happen? So this is the situation currently. What will happen to India going forward? And why we are having this kind of challenging situation in India right now? Because the way certain businesses were done for last 70 years, that has been stopped and new way of thinking is happening. And there are three, four broad reasons why these things are happening. And I'll give you some illustration. One is it is driven by technology. Second thing, it is a behavioral. Third thing is a regulatory. So I give some perspective to you guys. So for instance, if you look at auto numbers, auto is, some people say, is a barometer of Indian economy. Now look at new generation. If you just put a simple mathematics owning car in big city is not a good idea. The parking cost in your building will be 10 lakh to 25 lakh rupees. Right? Then you have insurance and everything. So what is happening? The youngsters are becoming very smart. They're saying no car. And they also don't want to have any house. So next generation perhaps is thinking very differently, which we can't appreciate. Many kids don't want to marry. Even they want to marry, they don't want to have kids. Which is a fact of the life. It's unthinkable for us. When we were growing up, first thing, ghar le lo, shadi kar lo, ghar le lo, shadi kar lo. So we had a solution to every problem in life. So if I am not doing well, beta, shadi kar le, sab theek ho jayega. So I got married, I am not doing well, beta, bachcha paida kar le, sab theek ho jayega. So uncle said all solution to our problems, which again used to put in bigger problem. So we lived in that kind of situation. Today, youngsters don't want anything of that sort. So I tell you a very interesting story. It's anecdotal story, but it's tell you how youngsters are thinking. So one fine day, I want to become a good parent and have a great relationship with my kids, which in any case, you know, is a very difficult task, but still I was attempting to do it. So I told my son, keep dono bachcho ko baithke main dikhaya ki ye Mother India picture hai. Just see the Mother India movie. Now, if you see the Mother India movie, there's a story youngster may not know, but it's a very interesting story. It's an iconic movie in India where there's a Nargis. Her husband left her and she's in a village. She's almost like abandoned woman. And the village money lender is eyeing her. She struggled throughout her life to grow up both her kids and had a very tough life. And the kids grow in extreme poverty and the money lender was chasing her. She didn't marry money lender. And finally, in one scene, she shoots her son, the younger son. So I was telling my kids that, look, this is what Mother India is. This is what a woman of India should be. And my son turned and told me that, I think, Mom, Dad, the mother was very stupid. I said, why? Usne money lender se shaadi kyun nahi ki? Bachcho ko itna comfortable life hota tha. So, for 30 years, we were taken from the school to go and see the movie. So, entire school went to watch the movie. It was tax-free in Rajasthan at that time. And for 30 years, we lived in assumption. It is a great story. And my son turned it around in different ways. It's a fact of the life. So we are living in a very different thing. So next generation will think very differently. In US, more than 50% of people throughout their life live in rented apartments. In India, we have fascination to have a boy child. We have fascination to have a house. We have fascination to have a status symbol. I think youngsters are no longer bothered about these things. So we are going to see a different kind of country. Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. In 2019, central government allocated 57,000 crore to Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. State government contributed equal amount of money, 57,000 crore. The end user who are buying house of 2 lakh to 6 lakh crore, 6 lakh rupees, contributed 80,000 crore. Now, that kind of money would have gone to buy autos and discretionary spending, has gone to buy a house. We don't see these kind of things because headlines are very different. So I tweeted today morning, last year I was reading an article written by a newspaper that in festive season, the flight fares has went up. So it's bad for the economy. This year they didn't go, so it's bad for the economy. So we are living this kind of world where things are seen or perhaps sensations are being created. But don't go by the first level of thinking. You need to develop your own level of thinking to make money in the market. For me, what worked for me is that to have open mind, not guided by any theory, because I believe no theory works permanently in this world. And I'll tell you two interesting statements I'll make you. There's a one famous quote which is being wrongly ascribed to Albert Einstein that power of compound is the eighth wonder of the world. He didn't say that, but still it is after him. So let's assume that he said that. The power of compounding is the eighth wonder of the world. Let's assume it. Now, what will happen to power of compounding in negative interest rate scenario? Just think of it. You are losing 2%, 1% every month, every year. So does power of compounding work the other way around? So the eighth wonder of the world has been taught to us for like 50, 60, 70 years. Now the event in the world is telling you, I don't know what will happen to power of compounding. Harvard Marks, the current poster boy of Wall Street, managed Oaktree, he said something very interesting. He said, everything is AAA at the right price. The credit event in India doesn't justify that. So I'm saying there are no God in the market. I hope you're getting it. Build your own thought process, build your own path, because that is what is going to work for you. You can't make money from borrowed intelligence. You need to build your own ecosystem. In the business of investing, there are no right or wrong answer. It's like eating. Kisi ko paneer tikka pasand hai, kisi ko pet mein badhajmi karta hai. So you need to build your own ecosystem and figure out what works for you. If you are in the business of investment advisory, then keep one thing in simple thing in mind. If you want to play for the long term, just think, will this strategy make money for my investor? If the answer is yes, follow it. If the answer is no, I don't know what to do. So I have a very simple rule of investing. I'm like a chef. If I have to serve a dish, I have to eat it first. So if I have to recommend an investment solution to my investor, I have to buy it first. Otherwise, I'll not recommend anything to my investors. I follow a very simple rule. And luckily, it has worked wonderfully well for me till date. So this is, in my opinion, what you should be doing. One little side issue you should keep in mind. The biggest differentiator in next 20 to 30 years is this. I don't know what will happen, what will change, what will don't change, I don't know. I can't control, I can't figure out what will change, what will not change. But I can just figure out what will not change. So focus on things which will not change. So what will happen? One very interesting input I'll give you. As it has been said very often that the time is the friend of the greatest businesses and the time is the enemy of bad businesses. So if you are your own business model, the best thing you should do is to increase your energy level, increase the longevity of your career. How can you do that? The most important thing you will do and you should do is to keep good health. Most fundamental thing you will do, keep good health. Health is something which is least envied and most enjoyed. So if you want to live a good life, and that will create a big difference over the next 20, 30 years. A healthier person will have 25 hours in 24 hours. His working life will not be 40, 45, 50. He will look 60, 70, 80. And that will create lots and lots of gap between you and the next person. Suppose in exam, some student have 40 hours to study and somebody has 80 hours or 60 hours to study. Who will do well? 60 hours. So that thing you need to focus. So this is about life. This is about investing. What is happening in India currently? So in my opinion, a lot of these changes are driven by the policymaker. So suppose you go and talk to them, they know, yes, we know this is happening, but it's driven by us. So one group of people from Mumbai reached out to the policymaker in Delhi. I'll not name, you'll know who the person is. So they told, it was jewelry association, they told, ki, sir, gold pe thoda duty kam kar dijiye. तो बोला कितना कम करना बोला जीरो कर दीजिए बोला ठीक है जीरो कर देंगे गोल्ड पे ड्यूटी बोला 850 टन इंडिया में इंपोर्ट होता है गोल्ड आप उसका बिलिंग करा दीजिए हाँ अब बिलिंग तो 850 का होता नहीं है बिलिंग तो 1100-1200 एक्चुअल में होता है बिकॉज 20% तो मिलावट ही है अगर एक्चुअल बिलिंग करने लगा तो मालूम पड़ेगा 850 टन तो इंपोर्ट हुआ है और 1200 करोड़ का बिलिंग हो रहा है 10000 करोड़ का बिलिंग हो रहा है 1100 करोड़ का बिलिंग हो रहा है सो large number of these things are driven by policymaker. It is not that they are not aware about these things. They are acutely aware about these things. But they say, we are changing India. Is good or bad? I don't know. As a market participant, as a money manager, it is not my job to argue with what policymakers are doing. It is their job to do. I need to figure out, in the given situation, how do I make money for my investors? We don't argue with invest policymaker. We don't argue with the policies. We don't argue with what people in the market are saying or doing. We want to make money out of people's stupidity. And we have been very, very successful doing it. One level of thinking is to figure out what crowd is doing and do it. Second level of thinking is figure out what crowd is doing and perhaps many times not doing what crowd is doing. And that will differentiate you. I'm not necessary that you have to become contrarian for the sake of being contrarian, but build your own independent thought process. An independent thought process is not built in a day. You need to read and spend years figuring out, and in spite of that, you will not be 100% sure, and that is a great thing. In the business of investing, there are no certainty. So there are no fixed formula. Only one formula I know, which has, in my opinion, has worked, and in perhaps will continue to work, is reversal to mean. It means anything which goes up ultimately comes down, everything which goes down ultimately will come up. So what is happening in India right now is a churning. Samudra manthan ho raha hai, to kaam dhenu gai bhi aayegi, chinta mani bhi aayega, lekin uske pehle vish aa raha hai abhi. Yes, so you will see a lot of people, lots of promoter behind the bar. Not the bar which we want to go in the evening. So you will see that trend continue to happen. Great thing about India is that, I tell you something, we have a huge native intelligence. You should take advantage of native intelligence. In India, mein jo bhi promoter abhi takleef mein hai na, hum sabko malum hai, log chor hai. We are a great native intelligence. It was not that, like in US, Lehman kind of organization was hero worshipped. The people whose stocks are down 90-95%, they were never hero worshipped. We knew a chor hai. Sabko malum tha log chor hai, sabko malum tha log badmashi kar rahe hai. So India mein we have a huge native intelligence. I worked in Birla Group and I had a good fortune of working with Aditya Babu for a 1 year period. I was his EA. They had a parta system. Birla ka parta system. You know what is a parta system? Cost kitna hai, ghar mein kitna paisa hai, matlab galle mein kitna paisa hai, aaj cash kitna aaya, aaj cash kitna bana. It took Harvard University 50 years to figure out cash is king. So I'm not saying we don't need to learn from the various parts of the world, but two, three things, in my opinion, would work wonderfully well in the stock market is that one is reversal to mean, and for that matter, in any other asset category, one is reversal to mean. Second thing is that cash is king. Third thing, in my opinion, you should not invest on the basis of view. You should do fact-based investing, not view-based investing. I hope you are getting it. You should do fact-based investing, not view-based investing, because view have the probability of going wrong. And in the business of investing, if your probability is 50%, it is zero-sum game, very difficult to make money on the long-term basis. So this is my perspective on the investing. What we are going to see in India, India GDP is hitting 5%. What will happen to the market? What will happen to economy? What is the situation going to be next 1 to 2 to 3 years? Would you like to hear that? Okay. So before I start, here's a very small disclaimer. I'm predicting about the market, predicting about the economy, so very small disclaimer. कि कभी कभी यूं ही हमने अपने दिल को बहलाया है जिन बातों को खुद नहीं समझे औरों को समझाया है. सो आई विल स्टार्ट विद दैट डिस्क्लेमर. सो देयर इज एनबीएफसी क्राइसिस, बैंक्स आर नॉट लैंडिंग, वी आर गोइंग थ्रू दैट काइंड ऑफ क्राइसिस. टिपिकली M3, द मनी इन द सिस्टम इज इन शॉर्ट सप्लाई इंडिया करेंटली. It will get sorted out in 6 months to 1 year time. The market will bottom out before the economy bottom out. In our opinion, India's GDP is going to hit 7 to 8% growth in maybe 1.5 to 2 year time, but market will start discounting that at least 1 year before. 10% GDP growth, we have a potential. Whether we'll be able to achieve that, I don't know, but at least we are able to go back to average number of 7%. There are lots of things happening in our economy which are very, very good. So I give you two, three illustrations. Road connectivity. In India, till year 2000, only 15% of rural India was connected through road. Today, that number is almost 90%. When you connect people to the road, labor movement becomes very easy. Labor is the most perishable commodity. So people start moving out. There's more auto sales happening. The product of villages can reach to the city. City product can reach to the villages. So that is happening. Second thing, tele-density. Around year 2004, rural India had a 7-8% tele-density. Right now it is 55%. Now what does tele-density does? Tele-density makes you more productive. Don't look at urban India and the mobile phone. There's a different issue altogether. But when you're a part of a group, you get employed very fast. One simple illustration was in Kerala. Before the arrival of mobile telephony, there was a huge fluctuation in the prices of fishes. The fluctuation was 50 to 60%. After the arrival of mobile telephony, the volatility in the food prices is only 5 to 7% of fishes. Because now the fishermen who goes, they know what is the situation in the market. If there are too many fishes, they don't go for the fishing. And if there are lack of fishes, they go and fish as they will rest. So that kind of things are happening. So these are, at the bottom of the pyramid, we are seeing huge changes. On the top end, there are problems. And this is not going to, if you look from the old perspective, it is not going to change. Isme yahan pe kaafi log bujurg bhi hain. 60s, 70s mein movie aati thi. Un movies mein Rai Saab hua karte, Rai Saab. Malum hai? Aur generally heroine ke father hua karte. Toh hero toh garib hi hota tha. Toh Rai Saab ka Rai Saab ko introduce kaise kiya jata tha? Ki Rai Saab hai, Rai Saab ke paas ek rice mill hai, ek oil mill hai, ek dal mill hai, ek textile mill hai. Aisa introduction hota tha Rai Saab ka. Agar aaj aapke paas ye charon cheeze to aap NCLT ke member ho. So we can't see things from old prism. There are new ideas, new technology, new things are needed. So one part. What is happening to India very interestingly? Something which has not been studied properly. Who is taking all the money? When you see traffic is there, when you see the rest, go to restaurants are full, movie theaters are full, flights are full, everywhere there's a lot of action happening, but GDP is not expanding and there's a lack of profitability. What is the reason? So I'll tell you some interesting stuff there. If you look at total profit of Nifty companies, it is around 2,25,000 to 2,50,000 crore. Okay? YouTube alone, last year, made 1,250 crore ad revenue out of India, which is 0.5% of Nifty profitability. Google's India revenue was 10,000 crore. Just think of these numbers. Now, I'll tell you two, three more ideas. Indians put together has remitted money in form of travel, medical tourism, education. Last financial year, close to 1 lakh crore. Kitna? If you look at in this group, for most wealthy Indian, one of the biggest discretionary item of spending is foreign travel and educating kids abroad. When you educate kids abroad, the expenses are 50 lakh to 2 crore rupees. When you go abroad and travel for a family of four, minimum expense are 10 lakh rupees. Very few Indian companies make money there. So these kind of things are happening. To counter that, India needs huge capital investment, which is the effort of this government. The trade war between India and China is actually not a trade war. You know it is not a trade war. What is then this? What is this then? Is what kind of war is this? No, it's a technology war. China have a more AI patent than US. Chinese company Tencent introduced a mobile game. Okay? In 24 hours, that game become the number one downloaded in 24 countries. But that was not allowed in China. So we are living in information warfare. People will take advantage of fault line in India, either through NGOs or whatever, whatever. We need to vary of these things. So that is the reason that lots of efforts are being put in place where high investment or investment to capital intensive industries are being invited to kickstart Indian economy, and that will happen. First time India has become, I don't know whether you guys are aware or not, India has become net exporter of mobile phones. Yeah, you become net exporter of mobile phone. Now we're talking about so much negativity in the system. The capacity utilization in steel industry has hit 85%. India has become net importer of steel last month. So what will happen when your capacity hitting 85%, the CFO start preparing plan to set up more steel plant. So all these things will, over a period of next 1 to 2 years, will take India back to 8-7%, in my opinion, 7-7.5% GDP expansion. So future of this country, in my opinion, is very bright. I remain India bull. You're going to make lots of money. You will get employed at decent places. And I wish all the good luck to you, your entire team, and the youngest student. Thank you very much.
Hello. I think kuch questions to puchne chahiye, although hamara time permit nahi karta hai, but ek ya do question main zarur nahi sir ko wired on. Okay, chalega. To aise rockstar ke liye ek bar aur zordar taali ho jaye, kyunki wo setup dekh ke aisa lag raha tha ki rockstar hai. Sir, ek data hai government ka, which says that ke 6 crore SSCs hai approximately, about 98,000 logon ne 1 crore and above ka return file kiya hai. Okay, and about 5 lakh log salaried class mein jinhone 1 crore and above ka return file kiya hai. Sir, ye sab dekh ke aisa nahi lagta hai ki it's lot of things which are, because I know where I stay, maybe in South Mumbai, Central Mumbai, there would be more than about 100,000 people would be about that bracket. So ye data aisa kyun hai ki jahan pe ye overall India ka jo data hai, ye kya dikha raha hai? Where are we? Are we really hiding, or there is something that we are not able to find out ki kya ho raha hai from this data? Because if I see, there are, for that 1 lakh iPhone 11X, there is a huge queue. So where is this money coming up? There is about 200 crores, 500 crores, every movie is being done. So ye kya ho raha hai, sir? Ye distinct kya hai? What is this disjunct?
Ye kya dikhata hai? Hum tax chor hai. We don't want to pay taxes, as simple as that. Morally, we take, intellectually we are very high. Morally, ethically, India is not a good country. And you look at any community, leader in any community are the biggest tax chores. So I wrote an article for Economics Time where I suggested that if government want to increase tax taxation, then they need to reward the good behavior. So a couple of suggestions I gave. Aap koi mandir mein chale jaiye, bade bade mandiron mein, matlab tiles pe naam likha hai, iski smriti mein diya, iski smriti mein. People want that kind of effort. So I said ki, aap koi bhi community mein bolo ki top leader will be the highest taxpayer. Koi is community, koi yahan pe, is area mein jo highest taxpayer kiya 5 saal, uske naam pe road hogi, uske naam pe chowk banega. Aap stadium hai, IPL ke ticket hai, start reserving 5% for the highest taxpayer. Taxpayer ko bolo ki aapko 2% quota education institution mein milega. Taxpayer ko bolo ki aapko separate airlines ke andar aapko separate security system milega, aapke liye VVIP launch milega. Why VVIP launch should be there for the politician? Why not for the honest taxpayer? So if the government want a good behavior, then they should reward good behavior. It's a very simple thing. But बट ये हो जाए, आप चिंता मत करिए. अभी 200% टैक्स पेनल्टी हो गई है. पेरू इज अ कंट्री विच लर्न फ्रॉम यूएस, एंड यूएस एज अ रूल वेयर इफ यू डोंट पे टैक्स यू गो टू जेल. इट विल हैपन, बट वी वांट गुड ट्रैफिक, बट वी डोंट टू फॉलो ट्रैफिक रूल्स. हमारे भी सिस्टम जोरदार है ना, हम भी इतने वायर्ड हैं ऐसे कि हमको सब कुछ चाहिए लेकिन कुछ देना नहीं अपने हाथ से. तो वो जब तक चेंज होगा नहीं, बट मोदी जी कर रहे हैं. ठीक है संदीप भाई.
हेलो. लोग कहते हैं कि अभी मंदी का दौर चल रहा है, और उस मंदी के दौर को लोग डीमोनेटाइजेशन से कनेक्ट कर रहे हैं कि भाई डीमोनेटाइजेशन के कारण लिक्विडिटी नहीं है फंड की, और उसी की वजह से मंदी चल रही है. क्या रियली मंदी चल रही है या लोग खाली बातें कर रहे हैं?
बहुत अच्छा.
सबका प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, देखो अपना जो अच्छे खाते पीते लोग हैं उन लोगों का प्रॉब्लम है. वी लिव इन इको चैम्बर वेर एवरीबडी इज गॉट इम्पैक्टेड, इज अ फैक्ट ऑफ द लाइफ. पीपल एट द बॉटम ऑफ द पिरामिड्स आर वेरी हैप्पी. आप और मैं गाड़ी में बैठते हैं, मोदी जी ने वाट लगा दी, अपना ड्राइवर सुनता है, बोला सेठ का वाट लग रहा, मजा आ गया. हम घर पे रिश्तेदार आते हैं, बात करते हैं, मोदी जी ने वाट लगा दिया, अपनी काम वाली बाई सुनती है, बोला अच्छा हुआ, मैं 5,000 रुपये मांग रही थी, दिया नहीं उधार, अभी देखो. सो इन वन वे डिमोनेटाइजेशन वॉन यूपी इलेक्शन फॉर, ऐसा बोलते हैं. सिस्टम में लिक्विडिटी है, लेकिन क्या हो रहा है, देखिए कि जब वाइट का एक ब्लैक का पैसा होता है, वाइट का पैसा होता है, आदमी ब्लैक का पैसा बहुत जल्दी खर्च करता है, उसका सर्कुलेशन फास्ट होता है, वाइट का पैसा आदमी इतना जल्दी खर्च नहीं करता. जैसे मेरी वाइफ गई कहीं और बोला कि मुझे ज्वेलरी सेट पसंद आया, उसको 2,00,000 रुपये खरीदना कैश है, वो खरीद लेगी. अब मुझे बोलती कि फंड ट्रांसफ़र करो, कैसे होगा? आपने घर में शादी की डेकोरेशन का लगाना है, डेकोरेशन में 20,00,000 रुपये खर्च, उसका ऊपर 18% GST है और 20,00,000 भी पोस्ट टैक्स, इफेक्टली आपको 40,00,000 खर्च करने हैं, तो आप बोलोगे 20,00,000 नहीं करते यार. और 3-4 बड़े कारण हैं. एक बड़ा कारण है कि पिछले 10-12 सालों में हर आम आदमी ने इतना रियल इस्टेट में पैसा घुसाया, दैट इज किल्ड द लिक्विडिटी इन द सिस्टम. आज आपके पास दुकान लगा के साड़ियाँ बेचते थे, साल में 20,00,000 रुपये कमाया आपने, आपने 20,00,000 रुपये रियल इस्टेट में डाला, एक साल में, 2 साल में, 5 साल में 1 करोड़ रुपये हो गया, तो आपको लगा कि यार एक धंधा अच्छा है. नेक्स्ट ट्रेंच आपका 5 करोड़ का इन्वेस्टमेंट हुआ, 5 का 7 भी बन गया तो आपने 10 करोड़ डाला. सो इंडिया में सबसे बड़ा, मेरे हिसाब से, वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम, और रियल इस्टेट में आपने पैसा डाला, वो पैसा गया कहाँ? बिल्डरों के पास गया, और बिल्डर ने वो पैसा साइफन करके पैसा बाहर ले गए. तो इफ़ यू रियली आस्क मी, द रूट कॉज ऑफ दिस स्लो डाउन इज नॉट शोन इन 2016, द सीड वॉज शोन इन 2006-7-8 ऑफ रियल इस्टेट बूम. और वो सारा पैसा लोग बाहर नहीं, आप देखें ना PMC का स्टोरी, PMC में 27,000 फेक अकाउंट है, वो फेक अकाउंट से लोन लिए गए, फेक अकाउंट से लोन ट्रांसफर कर दिया गया और वो पैसा चला गया बाद में बाहर. सो दैट इज व्हाट हैज हैपन एक्चुअली. तो इन माय ओपिनियन, यू आस्क मी वन असेट कैटेगरी विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल, और टू असेट कैटेगरी विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर इंडिया चैलेंजेस इज रियल इस्टेट एंड गोल्ड. यस, हाँ, गोल्ड वाला इसलिए बोल रहा हूँ सर कि आज इंडिया इज एनर्जी डिफिशियंट कंट्री. हम 85% एनर्जी इम्पोर्ट करते हैं, हमारा इम्पोर्ट बिल बढ़ता है, एनर्जी का तो कोई तोड़ नहीं है. सेकंड बिगेस्ट आइटम इज गोल्ड, वो पूरा इम्पोर्ट होता है कि नहीं? तो आप में देशभक्ति है. I can't say these things at home, so I think.
Thank you. I think let's have a round of applause for Vijay Bhai.